EV charging. This time, I will explain EV charging. In order to drive an EV, you need to charge it. I explained earlier that EV charging is divided into DC charging and AC charging, right?
Yes.
However, there are various types of charger ports, so you should be familiar with what ports are applied to your vehicle. The types of EV charger ports include combo type, AC three-phase, CHAdeMO, and others. The latest models of Kia EVs use a combo type, in which DC charging and AC charging ports are unified. And this type is applied as combo 1 and 2, depending on the region. It's easier to understand if you think about the shape of the plugs used in different countries. See these two types of chargers? One is a DC charger, and the other is an AC charger. First, let me explain DC charging. DC charging is a method of quickly charging EVs with at least 50 kilowatts of high-powered, direct current at present. In the case of the Niro EV, it takes 54 minutes from 0% to 80% SOC when charged with 100 kilowatts. But even among the same charger type, charging time may vary depending on the power available, battery temperature, and vehicle condition. And in the case of DC charging, it lowers the charging power and charges slowly from SOC over 80% to protect the battery from overheating. Now, let me show you how to charge EVs.
Sure.
1. Press the button on the stand. 2. Insert charging connector. 3. Remaining charging time and amount displayed on cluster. 4. Charging lamp lights up. Secondly, AC charging is a method of charging the battery using alternating current with low output. So it takes quite a long time from 0% to 100%, between 10 to 30 hours. Therefore, EVs are usually charged by AC charging when not in use or during the late night when electricity rates are low. Unlike DC chargers, there are various types of AC chargers, such as stand type, wall type, and portable charger. Iccb is Kia's portable charging cable that can be used in common electrical outlets. I'll show you how to charge EVs with an Iccb. 1. Insert charging connector. 2. Iccb information display. 3. Remaining charging time and amount displayed on cluster. 4. Charging lamp lights up.
Now I know how to charge it, but what if someone steals my personal Iccb when I'm charging my EV with it?
That's something you may be concerned about, but don't worry. For Kia EVs, you can adjust the locking device through the auto lock button. As in the case you've mentioned, when using a personal charger, release the auto button to switch to lock mode. Then it's securely locked before, during, and after charging. However, if you are using a charger that is shared with others, it would be good to activate the auto button and set the charger to lock only when it is charging.
Oh, I see. Now I can easily distinguish the various elements of charging.
I'm glad you understand. Any more questions?
Well, I'd like to try charging it myself, if that's all right.
Of course. Shall we start charging? Charging condition.
Huh? The charging door isn't opening. What's wrong?
Shall we go through the charging conditions step by step? First of all, if the vehicle door is locked, the charging door will not open, so be sure to unlock the vehicle first. Then press the push button on the right end of the charging door.
I see. Then, can it be charged even in the ready state?
Yes. If you connect the charger to the vehicle in the ready state, it will automatically turn off for safety, and charging will start. Of course, the shifting lever must be in the P range.
The charging still does not start.
If the charging does not start immediately, you should check whether scheduled charging has been set. If you want to charge immediately, press the scheduled charging deactivation button. In addition, if the current SOC is higher than the target SOC, charging cannot start. In this case, you can change the settings in the AVN. If charging starts normally, you can also find information on charging, such as the state of charge and remaining time on the cluster panel. Furthermore, you can intuitively check the charging status of the vehicle through the LED lamp on the top of the crash pad outside the vehicle. You can also see information such as abnormality during charging or scheduled air conditioning heating. Now, the SOC is 50%, so the first lamp is on and the second lamp is blinking.
It would be useful since I can see the charging status at a glance from outside.
You can select a suitable current through the AVN when performing AC charging. It is better to adjust the input current according to the allowable power value. In particular, in an old house or when several electronic products are used at the same time.
I see. In that case, I should adjust it by lowering it a little.
Yes, the charging current can be controlled through the Iccb, just like the AVN. There is a small switch on the back of the Iccb. If you press and hold this switch before connecting the cable to the vehicle, you can adjust the charging current to high, medium, or low, according to the charging environment. And if you press and hold this switch while charging, charging will stop. Let's try charging with the Iccb and see what information is displayed on the LCD. If you look at the Iccb LCD, you can see the display changes through the charging process. You can also check if the Iccb itself or the vehicle or outlet has a problem through the warning lights displayed on the Iccb.
Ah, I don't have to worry since all the fault conditions are reported.
Yes. It looks like the car was charged sufficiently during my explanation.